chances are good that if you don't already use the automatic camera preset recall plugin, that at least you've heard about it and thought, hey, that sounds pretty cool. Well, it is, because it uses audio in the room to determine which camera preset to recall. And it's even cooler now. Let me show you some of the new features we've added as of version 3. First, we now support the Q-SYS NMT1 tabletop conferencing microphone and the Audio-Technica ATND1061 Dante-enabled microphone, in addition to the Sennheiser TCC2 and discrete microphones that were supported before. The second new feature you may have already noticed, these new audio pins. Now we can route the microphone's audio directly into the plugin. The NMT1's audio is wired just like discrete mics, but we've added a tab here in the plugin to make it easy to set up. We can tell the plugin to reference it using its script access code name. This code name is for external control and scripting purposes, and we can edit it here in the properties panel. Next, if we're using the AT or Sennheiser mics, we can now just enter their IP information here in the microphone tab. This means that in the case of the TCC2, we don't need to use its plugin anymore to access its coordinate data. Also in the microphone tab, we've added new PTZ controls that let us adjust the active camera right here in the plugin. We have new active buttons here that let us not only activate a zone before we define a range, but we can also control these to deactivate zones if we don't need them based on the current setup of the room. We can assign labels to our zones now, and we can tell Q-SYS to prefer the secondary camera for a zone using this new button. This could be beneficial if your primary and secondary cameras aren't right next to each other, and maybe you prefer the view of the secondary camera for that particular zone. If we enable the Expert Controls tab, we'll see some new threshold detection controls to fine-tune our mic as well as the far-end audio. And if you were using a previous version of the plugin, we've made it really easy to transfer all of your current settings into the new version. Just copy the code name from its properties panel here and paste it down here in the new plugin. Hit Copy, and we get confirmation that everything successfully transferred over. This does include the script access code names you've already assigned for your cameras and routers. Remember, if you're configuring a new plugin from scratch, you'll need to be sure to assign those code names here under script access. Finally, we've added crossover zones. Let's say a meeting participant is sitting in a position that lies between two microphones. Well, the plugin considers the mic with the loudest signal to be active, and it'll recall whichever camera preset that points to that mic's active zone. So, if two mics are active back and forth in this crossover zone, we could have them both trying to recall two different camera presets, and that would be pretty annoying. To keep that from happening, when we're using supported Sennheiser or AT beamforming mics, the last four zones of the plugin are now reserved for these crossover zones. These zones have two separate sets of horizontal and vertical angles that we can input. This will let us copy and paste the angle settings from both of the mics that are hearing this zone equally and use them instead in this new crossover zone. This is telling Q-SYS, okay, this crossover zone we're creating is going to take over when this back and forth issue happens. We'll grab these PTZ coordinates from camera 1 and copy them here. Then we can say that here we want to use camera 1. And let's select microphone 2 as the active mic. And we can name this zone here. Now, once we deactivate the original overlapping zones, we can let this new crossover zone handle our in-between area. Well, that's a lot of great new stuff. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.